Hello, my dear students. I am Rajkumar Kalia, your best tutor online, trying to make math simple for you people and getting appreciations from you. Thanks for that. Today I am going to teach you my first principle, trigonometric functions. Trigonometric functions by first principle. Trigonometric functions by first principle. So first is differentiate sine x with respect to x. As usual, we have 5 steps to do. First step, let y equals to the function to be differentiated. First is, let y equals the function to be differentiated. Second, y to y plus delta y. Y to y plus delta y. X to x plus delta x. Third, 2 minus 1. From 2 subtract 1. That is 2 minus 1 and solve. Fourth, divide throughout. By delta x. Fifth, taking limit. As delta x approaches 0, delta y approaches 0. These are the 5 steps to be used. Now sine x, first step, let y equals sine x. Let y equals sine x. Second, y to y plus delta y, x to x plus delta x. 2 minus 1, that is y plus y, y plus delta y, minus y, sine, x plus delta x, minus sine x. Y we can cancel, delta y, use here the rent t. Sin c minus sin d. Sin c minus sin d is 2 cos c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2. This is empty we will use. So here take it as c and x as d. 2 cos c plus d x plus delta x plus x by 2 sine x plus delta x minus d by 2 by using this identity. So it will come out to be delta y equals 2 cos 2x plus delta x by 2 sin 2. By solving, this is what we will get. Fourth step, dividing throughout by delta x. Delta y by delta x. Two cos 2x plus delta x by 2 sine delta x by 2 by 2 divided by delta x. So when we will divide by delta x, you are supposed to write it like this. One identity we have in trigonometry: limit theta approaches 0 sine theta by theta equals 1. This limit we know, though it's now not in your syllabus and you have not done it, but you have to learn it. Limit theta approaches 0 sine theta by theta is 1. And here we have sine delta x by 2. In the denominator we have delta x. We want to make it by 2. I have divided it by 2, so I have to multiply also it by 2 to keep the balance. Thus this 2 and 2 we can cancel. 2 and 2 we can cancel. This is what here you will get after dividing. Then taking limit. Limit delta x approaches 0. Delta y by delta x. Limit delta x approaches 0 cos 2x plus delta x by 2 delta x by 2 sine delta x by 2. Now when we will solve it, left we will write it as dy by dx. Left we will write it as dy by dx. For right, where there is delta x put 0, cos 2x, for delta x 0 by 2. This collectively by using the limit. Angle is same as denominator. It will come out to be 1. Thus this 2, 2 we can cancel. It will come out to be cos 6. So thus the differential of sin x is a cos x. That is how you are supposed to do it by first principle. It's not at all tough. Go for the steps. Put the function equals y to y plus delta y, x to x plus delta x, 2 minus 1, and solve it. While solving, here you are using the identity sin c minus sin d equals 2 cos c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2. delta y equals u z and t divided by delta x. Here one adjustment is required. We are getting sine delta x by 2 in the denominator only delta x. Divided by 2, so multiply by 2. This multiplying factor we can cancel in denominator and numerator. So we will get cos 2x plus delta x by 2 and then sine delta x by 2 by delta x by 2. So take the limit, when we will use the limit, left will come out to be dy by dx. Here where there is delta x put 0, and for this as a whole it is identity 1, thus it will come out to be cos x. So that is the differentiation of sin x by first principle. Now let's go with cos x. Next is differentiate cos x with respect to x. Differentiate cos x with respect to x by first principle. So as usual, go for 5 steps. First step, let y equals cos x. Second, y to y plus delta y, x to x plus delta x. So we'll get y plus delta y cos x plus delta x. Third, 2 minus 1, 2 is y plus delta y, minus 1 means left side y, then here cos x plus delta x minus cos x, y we can cancel. Delta y cos c minus cos t minus 2 sin c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2. Cos c and t. Delta y minus 2 sin 2x plus delta x by 2 sin 2. Here I have used that in t. Cos c minus cos d is minus 2 sin c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2. So this is what you will get, delta y. Fourth, dividing by delta x. Delta y by delta x minus 2 sin 2x plus delta x by 2 sin delta x by 2 divided by delta x. Now see here, we have sin delta x by 2 over delta x. To make angle same, we will divide it by 2. We have divided it by 2, so So to keep the balance, we have to multiply by 2. This 2, 2 we can cancel. 2, 2 we can cancel. So this overall we will get delta x by 2 and delta x by 2, angles are same. So taking limit, limit delta x approaches 0, delta y by delta x minus sine 2x plus delta x by 2 sine 2x plus delta x by 2 sine delta x by 2 delta x by 2. Taking the limit, like that we are supposed to solve. Write this type. Limit delta x approaches 0, delta y by delta x equals this negative sign, limit delta x approaches 0 sine 2x plus delta x by 2 sine delta x by 2 over delta x by 2. Then we will use the limit, we will get dy by dx equals negative sign sine 2x where there is delta x put 0 and this collectively is identity, that is 1. So overall we will get delta dy by dx equals minus sine 2x by 2, that is sine x. It's minus sine x. So differential of cos x is minus sine x. These are all the identities which you have to remember also later on to solve the sums. Differentiate tan x by first principle. So as usual we have to use the 5 steps. First step, let y equals tan x. As usual we have to go for 5 steps here. First is y equals tan x. Second, y to y plus delta y, x to x plus delta x. Third, subtract and solve, that is 2 minus 1. X plus delta x minus tan x, then delta y we can cancel, y we can cancel, delta y tan x plus delta x minus tan x delta y. Tan x can be written as sin x by cos x. Minus sin x
by cos x, delta y. Take LCM, cos x plus delta x, cos x. This we can cancel BL with cos x, sine x plus delta x minus cos x into cos x. By taking LCM, this is what we can cancel. So we will get the product of sine x plus delta x into cos x minus cos cos we can cancel, cos x plus delta x sine x. So thus it will come out to be sin a cos b minus cos a sin b, sin a minus b, cos x plus delta x cos x. I have used that and t sin a cos b plus cos a minus cos a sin b equals sin a minus b, sin a cos b minus cos a sin b sin a minus a b. This identity I have used here. Thus I will get delta y equals xx I can cancel, sine of delta x over cos x plus delta x into cos x. This is what I will get over. Fourth, dividing by delta x, delta y by delta x, equals sine delta x by delta x cos x plus delta x cos x. So just taking limit delta x approaches 0, delta y by delta x sine delta x by delta x cos x plus delta x cos x. Using limit dy by dx, this part as a whole will come out to be 1. For delta x put 0, cos x into x, cos x for delta x is 0, cos x plus 0 and then again cos x. Here we will get plus 0, or otherwise I am going to write it cos x plus 0 cos x. Thus dy by dx will come out to be 1 by cos x and cos x, that is 1 by cos square x So which can be written as secant square x. So that is the ddx of tan x by first principle. I hope remaining three you can do, or otherwise one I am going to solve, say secant x. Differentiate secant x by first principle. First step, let y equals secant x, y to y plus delta y, x to x plus delta x, by subtracting y plus delta y, that it is 2 minus 1, that is y plus delta y minus delta y secant x plus delta x minus secant x. Y we can cancel. Delta y we can put it as 1 by cos x plus delta x minus 1 by cos x delta y cos x plus delta x cos x LCM. This we can cancel. We are with cos x, then minus cos x plus delta x delta y. We can use the identity. Instead of c minus d, we will put c here. That is, you can say d minus c. So identity for cos d minus c will be 2 sin c plus d by 2 that is x plus delta x by 2 sin c minus d. See here, the identity which I have used is cos d minus cos c is 2 sin c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2. Cos d minus cos d is 2 sin c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2. If we will use it as c minus d, negative sign will come. Cos x plus delta x cos x. So thus sin xx we can cancel, xx 2x delta y 2 sine 2x plus delta x by 2 sine delta x by 2 cos x plus delta x cos x. Then dividing throughout by delta x, delta y by delta x, two sine 2x plus delta x by 2 sine delta x by 2 cos x plus delta x cos x. This is what we will get. And we have to divide by delta x also. Divide by delta x. So this is what we will get. Then here angle is sine delta x by 2. To make here delta x by 2, divide it by 2 and multiply it by 2. That is delta y by delta x equals 2 sine two x plus delta x by 2 x plus delta x by 2 sine delta x by 2 in the numerator we have cos x plus delta x cos x delta x. So to make it same as angle with the sine, divide by 2 and multiply by 2. Divide by 2 and multiply by 2. This 2 in the numerator, 2 in denominator we can cancel. And taking limit, this part will come out to be 1. So we will write it as now limit delta x approaches 0 delta y by delta x limit delta x approaches 0. We are now here with 2, 2 we can cancel. First we have to write here limit approaches 0. 2 we can cancel. Then sine 2x plus delta x by 2 sine delta x by 2. In the denominator, cos x plus delta x and cos x delta x by 2. Numerator will be sine 2x plus delta x by 2 sine delta x by 2. Then here cos x plus delta x cos delta x by 2. Now using the limit dy by dx, where there is delta x put 0, sine 2x plus 0 by 2, this part will come out to be 1, and we are with cos x plus delta x and cos x. So which will come out to be sine 2, 2 we can cancel x, cos square x, that is cos x and cos x. So 1 by cos x, reciprocal of cos is secant. Sine by cos is tan x. So like that we'll get differentiate sine x, that is differential of secant x as a secant x tan x. So remaining two similarly you can do. So at last again the same request. If you like it, you are finding I am explaining in a simple way, please subscribe and thumb it up, like it I mean. Subscribe, put the icon bell and thumb it. Thank you. Good night.